SSC Arts presents. Today we are going to see how to make pappu chekkalu or rice flour dumplings. These can be stored for about 1.5 to 2 months and are very crunchy evening snack or any perfect snack. The ingredients required are rice flour 1/2 kg. We need roasted chana dal or roasted gram dal, which is 1/4 cup. Chana dal, 1/4 cup. Moong dal or green dal, it is 1/4 cup. 1/4 cup of peanuts which are peeled. About 15 cashews. 1 teaspoon of jeera. About 2 teaspoons of til seeds. You can also take 1 teaspoon of ajwain. Salt as per your taste. Red chili powder as per your taste. Soak chana dal and moong dal for about 2 to 3 hours. Now in a mixy bowl, put the roasted chana dal and the peanuts. We are going to blend it, but not into a paste. We are coarsely going to blend it. The solid texture should be there. At the same time, it should become little powdery. Heat a pan and add oil to it. We are going to add oil for deep frying and oil while making the batter as well. That gives nice puffiness and crunchiness to the pappu chekkalu or rice flour dumplings. Take a big vessel and transfer the rice flour there. Add the coarse mixture of roasted chana dal and peanuts. Chop cashews into small pieces and add them. Add the moong dal. Drain out the water and add moong dal and also add the chana dal. Add til seeds. Add jeera. You can also add ajwain here. Add salt as per your taste. You can add a pinch of turmeric as well. Add red chili powder. Mix all of them really well. Now, take the oil, which is hot, and we are going to pour this oil. My mother uses about 3 to 4 teaspoons of ghee instead of oil. That gives a little more extra taste to it at this place. For deep frying, we are going to use oil only. Now mix little by little water. You can add hot water. Little hot water, boil it to lukewarm or little hot and then add it. And then make it into a dough, like a chapati dough. It should be thick as chapati dough. Now I have heated oil for deep frying. The dough is ready. So I'm going to take a lemon sized dough. Small lemon sized dough. Previously they used to do it on banana leaf. You can take a cover. You can put this dough on the cover and make it flat. If you have chapati maker, if you put this in the chapati maker and flatten it, you will get all equi-sized ones. Even for pani puri also, if you put the pani puri one in the chapati maker and make it flat, right? Because of that heat, it becomes nicely flat, right? So when you fry them, right, the pani puri bulge, and this one comes also in uniform shape and size. So I am spreading it on a polythene sheet. Now my oil is hot. So I am going to put one after other. Fry it in medium flame or else it will not be cooked inside. Once the oil is hot, turn it into medium or medium low flame. When it is golden on one side, I have flipped it onto the other side and I have taken it out. Yummy pappu chekkalu or rice flour dumplings are ready. After they have cooled only, place them in the jar. Airtight container, or else they ooze out water because of the heat. This can be stored up to 2 to 3 months.